I've just continued on with what I've previously said about the racial issue in early Eclipse, and how there seems to be the formation of a new caste system, which will be primarily white. And I want to tell you that there is a plan for such a thing. And this was taken up close to 100 years ago, where you have not only Europe, but the rest of the world turned into some sort of mixed polyglot race. And I'll just mention this person, who is the architect of such a thing. His name is Richard Nikolaus von Coudenhove-Kalergi. So Richard Nikolaus Ingiro, Count of Coudenhove-Kalergi, who was born November 16, 1894, and died July 27, 1972, was an Austrian politician, geopolitician, philosopher, and Count of Coudenhove-Kalergi, who was a pioneer of European integration. He was the founder and president for 49 years of the Pan-European Union. His parents were Heinrich von Coudenhove-Kalergi, an Austro-Hungarian diplomat, and Mitsuko Aoyama, the daughter of an oil merchant, antique dealer, and huge landowner family in Tokyo. His childhood name in Japan was Aoyama Ingiro. He became a Czechoslovak citizen in 1919 and then took French nationality from 1939 to his death. His first book, titled Pan-Europa, was published in 1923, contained a membership form for the Pan-Europa movement. Coudenhove-Kalergi's movement held its first congress in Vienna in 1926. And this is where you will see this guy was the architect for you would say a caste system. So he came from a very, especially say, noble aristocratic and wealthy family, wealthy parents. I'll continue on. This is an item that this is actually on Wikipedia. So if I'll continue on, under personal philosophy of his, aristocratic in his origins and elitist in his ideals, Coudenhove-Kalergi identified and collaborated with such politicians as Engelbert Dollfuss, Kurt Schuschnigg, Otto von Habsburg, Winston Churchill, and Charles de Gaulle. His ideal political constituent was a gentleman, a person adhering to honesty, fair play, courtesy, and rational discourse. He strove to replace the nationalist German ideal of racial community with the goal of an ethnically heterogeneous and inclusive European nation based on a commonality of culture. A nation whose geniuses were the great Europeans, such as Abbé de Saint-Pierre, Immanuel Kant, Napoleon, Giuseppe Mazzini, Victor Hugo, and Friedrich Nietzsche. So, just by looking at what we've come across so far, this guy was very, very elitist, which is quite unusual considering he was half Japanese. But as I said in my previous clip, we're going to see very white Asians, or very white Chinese, very white Jews, and very white Europeans, who are all of the same philosophy, religious type cult belief. They're going to start intermarrying because they want to establish a caste. We'll just look at his views on race and religion, and they're here. In his attitudes towards race and religion, Coudenhove-Kalergi continued the work of his father. In his youth, the elder Coudenhove-Kalergi was an anti-Semite. One word, not anti-Semite, means something different. He had expected to confirm his antipathy towards the Jews when he started working on his treatise, Das Wesen der Antisemitis. But Coudenhove-Kalergi came to a different conclusion by the time he published his book in 1901. That's the father, who was also an aristocrat and a diplomat. And you can read this for yourself on Wikipedia. And what it basically comes to is that by the time he finished writing it, he changed his mind for some reason. And we've got here, he branded every sort of anti-Judaism un-Christian. And we can see where this is reflected today with Christian Zionism, which is something, I don't know how you describe it. It's the Christian Zionists look at things like this. The Jews worship God, the Christians worship Jesus, and the Muslims worship the moon. And that all Jews are bound for heaven simply because of who they are, by a racial criterion that is really there isn't one, because anyone can be a Jew if they are accepted, as long as you are continuing the bloodline of the mother. If your mother is Jewish, well, so are you. And he had a book which I've yet to find completely in English, only bits and pieces. It was called Practitia Idealismus, meaning practical idealism. He wrote, "The man of the future will be of mixed race. Today's races and classes will gradually disappear owing to the vanishing of space, time and prejudice. The Eurasian-Negroid race of the future, similar in its appearance to the ancient Egyptians, will replace the diversity of peoples with a diversity of individuals." That's one of his quotes. And another one. "Instead of destroying European Jewry, Europe, against its own will, refined and educated this people into a future leader nation through this artificial selection process. No wonder that this people that escaped ghetto prison developed into a spiritual nobility of Europe. Therefore, a gracious providence provided Europe with a new race of nobility by the grace of spirit. This happened at the moment when Europe's feudal aristocracy became dilapidated, and thanks to Jewish emancipation." And we can see now how everything is coming together. It's political, economic, social, religious, esoteric. We can see all the works of all these rotten people, it's all coming up now. They're all going to interact with each other because that's what they were designed to do. I know, I used to be a Satanist. I used to get messages, "Now we have to take this earth. We have to capture it, take it away from God." Which to me at the time seemed, you know, I don't get it, but you obey. And I didn't understand that you just obey. But now I can understand why this earth is so important. And, you know, people worry about, oh, you know, die and you go to hell. But you better consider that there are people who want to establish hell on earth as it is now. And we are seeing this. It's, now I can only tell you what I know. But, you know, I'll continue on with this guy from another website. And I quote the website because I explained it quite frankly. It's called murderbymedia.wordpress.com. And I'll continue on with in the next clip. But I will tell you, check this out for yourself. I'll, you know, put out his name after I finish speaking, but check it out for yourself.